Do you take fish oil or another omega-3 supplement? If so, you are not alone. About 20 million people in the US take omega-3 supplements, mostly with the goal of preventing heart attacks and strokes. The question is, are they wasting their money or getting essential health benefits? The answer may depend on which type of omega-3 they are taking. Are fish oil supplements good for your heart? The story of fish oil and heart health started with the observation that some populations, like the Inuit, ate a lot of fatty fish yet had low rates of heart attack and stroke. A large Italian study published over 20 years ago showed that heart attack survivors who took omega-3 or fish oil supplements had a reduction in death, heart attack, and stroke. This led to the American Heart Association recommending fish oil supplements to patients with heart disease. However, several subsequent, more rigorous studies, such as the Vital study, failed to show a heart benefit from fish oil supplements. Because of the conflicting study results, cardiologists were split into two camps. While there was a general consensus that high dose, which is 3 to 4 grams per day of omega-3, was helpful in selected patients to lower triglycerides, when it came to prevention, some cardiologists still advocated for omega-3 supplements in high-risk patients, and some did not. Then came the study that changed everything. The Reduce-It trial studied high-dose pure EPA, that's a type of omega-3, called Icosapent Ethyl, in people with either established heart disease or at risk who had elevated triglycerides and were taking a statin medication. And the results were remarkable. Those who were taking the omega-3 supplement had a 25% reduction in heart disease and stroke and a 20% reduction in death from heart disease. The big question from the study is, why did this study have such a positive outcome when previous studies were either negative or weakly positive? Possible reasons include the higher dose used, 4 grams per day, or that the omega-3 was pure EPA and not the usual mix of EPA and DHA in most omega-3 supplements. The truth is, we don't know why Reduce-It was such a positive study. Yet multiple national and international medical societies now recommend Icosapent Ethyl in high-risk patients with elevated triglycerides who are taking a statin. So the question is, should you take omega-3 supplements? And the answer depends on who you ask. Here is what I tell my patients about omega-3 supplements. Number one, if there is a benefit to low dose, 1 gram per day fish oil supplements, it is likely small. Probably it's better to get omega-3 by eating fatty fish such as sardines, herring, albacore tuna, and salmon, among others. The American Heart Association recommends fish, particularly fatty fish, at least twice a week. Number two, high dose, meaning 4 grams per day of omega-3, can be effective in lowering high triglyceride levels. Number three, if you do decide to take an omega-3 supplement, find a high quality one manufactured from a reputable company. Number four, Icosapent Ethyl is reasonable for those at high risk for heart disease who have elevated triglyceride levels and are taking a statin. However, I'm still reluctant to make a strong recommendation based on a single study, especially when that study is not consistent with other similar studies. And then number five, be aware that there may be risk to omega-3 supplements as well. There is a small increase in bleeding, which is why I generally don't recommend omega-3 for my patients on strong blood thinner medication, and an increase in AFib was seen in the Reduce-It trial. The story of omega-3 and heart health is a complex one, and it is not complete. Talk to your doctor to see if omega-3 supplements are right for you, and stay tuned. This information is for educational purposes only and is not medical advice. Don't make any decisions about your medical treatment without first talking to your doctor. Thanks for watching. And if you want to learn more about living a long, healthy life you love, click the link below to learn more about how we help people increase their health span. And if you like this video, hit the like button below, share it with your friends, and be sure to hit the bell and subscribe.